So what you just saw was the stand-up convention, which is a one-of-a-kind in Japan, which is a convention that is dedicated to Vanguard and nothing else. Here I have a flyer of the next time that there will be a stand-up, so this will be the 27th edition. They tend to do about 4 of them a year. The next one is going to be on the 12th of February. I'm still going to attend that one because that's just before I leave back to Europe. So I will be attending that one. If you're in Japan for holidays in February or something and you're in Tokyo, then feel free to come as well. The entry fee is really small. It's like 500 yen or something, so it's about $5. It's pretty small for the kind of event that you get. So as you saw, there's a lot of people making their own merchandise, their own like necklaces, their own kind of like little badges, like these acrylic keychains and stuff that you see behind me in most videos these days. Like, I'll show you more of the merchandise after I'm done with this little monologue, but there's all kinds of amazing goods that these people put their love into and create for the people, for the Vanguard players themselves. So it's really, it's not so much for profit, it's so much that people love what they're doing, and they love the fact that, well, they have this community to share this experience with, and therefore they make this, and usually a lot of the merchandise is quite cheap too, so it's easy to get quite a lot for quite a small amount, and that makes it even better. And as you saw, there was also like cosplayers, and like, one of the things that made me realize about just Vanguard in Japan and about Vanguard in the world is that there are so many ways to enjoy Vanguard just without even playing the game. There are people who just enjoy the anime and they can either, you know, show that enjoyment by cosplaying or by drawing, by making like the kind of books that you saw, or like all these kinds of things, or making the keychains, making playmats, whatever it is. But there are so many ways to enjoy Vanguard without just being a competitive tryhard as we often see in the West. And what kind of, I guess, frustrates me is the right word, is that I know there are a lot of really talented people overseas as well. I can drop some random names off Twitter, like Scarlett, who makes amazing merchandise for Vanguard, like dices and like these kind of like acrylic items as well, and like all kinds of just like goods that are just unofficially made, and there's so much love and effort put into them, and there's just people all over the place making these kinds of things, like the necklaces you saw in stand-up. Like, I know that also there are like talents out in the West that make these kind of things, but sadly there isn't really the kind of person that's willing to bring all of them together into a con like this. But it also makes sense because the people in the West are obviously scattered all over the world, so it's gonna be harder than in Japan where they're all in one country so they can kind of come together at least. Or, well, it does take place in Tokyo, and the majority of people do live in Tokyo, so that kind of works out in a way. But it would be really amazing if there was something of this sort in the West, or let's say Bushiroad perhaps allowed in the regionals for people to be able to sell their unofficial merchandise. I think that's a very unlikely scenario. Or maybe if Bushiroad promoted these kinds of people, I think it would be quite nice, because these are all people that enjoy Vanguard in their own way. And it also goes to show that like, you don't have to be competitive. You don't even have to honestly play the game that much to enjoy Vanguard. Obviously, when I was walking around the circles and like the people that made all these merchandise, whether it was the people that wrote the books or drew the art or, you know, like created whatever, like keychains, etc., they were still playing games of Vanguard between each other, but they were playing it because they enjoy what the game does for them, and they want to convey that with their own craft, with their own talents, and turn it into enjoyment for everybody. So if you are someone that enjoys Vanguard in some other way, like whether it's drawing art or just creating nice little like bracelets or anything like that, then, you know, if anything, if there's no this kind of event happening in the West, then at least you can always feel free to just ping me on Twitter, and I'll always share this kind of thing, because to me this is just amazing. And when I first heard about it, I was like, what? There are people making like bracelets and stuff of Vanguard? Like, that was just amazing to me. Like, I've been playing this game since the start, and like, this is the first time I hear about it, and it's been going on for so long, and you just don't hear about it in the West. So I really wanted to share this event with you guys, and I'm very thankful to all the circles that allowed me to record them. I dropped the names of, you know, all the world, the links or the handles of the different circles that were doing their merchandise that I was allowed to film, if I did manage to find them. There were some that didn't, that's perfectly understandable, like some people don't want to be seen online, which is perfectly fine, or like in video form, like there's always some reason, so it's perfectly fine. So that's basically my little monologue. I really support these kind of people. I think, honestly, it's super amazing, and if you're one of them as well, then like feel free to just let me know. I'm gonna share it because I want others to see what kind of amazing things you're creating, because honestly, like, this fascinates me, and I'm sure a lot of other people would also be fascinated to have some merchandise of their favorite cards, like whether it's Thavas or Daikaiser in my case, or Night Rose in somebody else's case. Like, there's so many things that people love about the game, and, you know, they want to enjoy them without, you know, apart from just playing them. So that's gonna be it for my little rant, well, monologue-y kind of talk, and let's move on to the merchandise that I picked up at the event before we conclude this video. I'll start off with the non-literature, I guess. First, you might have seen that I have this, like, DP, Dimension Police deck case always sitting around here. I got that last time my friend KenYusagi went to the previous one when I couldn't and got that for me, but now I went to the same person's circle and got the Nova Grappler one. So it has Victor, it has the Blouse, it actually has every single archetype that exists in the clan, and then it has like one of them each featured on like each side of the box. So that's really nice. So that's another deck case from that exact same person. So I really like it. I mean, I'm a mecha type of guy, so obviously I'm gonna love it. Then, what you'll be currently seeing is my collection of the keychains and stuff that I picked up there from various circles. I decided to put them all up on my pinboard as a kind of decoration. I think it works a bit better than that, like that. There's some that I didn't that I'll quickly show off close up. So those being this cool machining kind of like crafted necklace, well, more of a keychain, but it's like this like heavy actual like metal one, and then a Verno keychain that is for my friend, which is why it's not hung up, and then the Ritual keychain, which is the circle, well, the circle logo, one of the circles that I was allowed to film. And now, well, you know, a lot of the necklaces there were mostly, you know, female based, but I kind of wanted to pick one up just because it looked nice. It's a Silverthorn one. I just like the design. Obviously I couldn't wear this. It's also, I think, way too small for my hand, but it might make a nice gift for someone in the future. But for now, I kind of like just the design. It works really well as a look here, or Silverthorn theme one. So I really just like the design of it, basically. And now for the more literature-y stuff. One circle that I was unfortunately not allowed to film does release a lot of books, or like half books, half manga. And they mostly do, I think they do a new Mega Colony one every single stand-up, but they also did a couple of Dimension Police ones. So here's one with a few grade 2s on it, and then here's one with this beautiful Daiyusha right there. So these are, I can't show the, you know, inside of it because that would be very disrespectful to the actual artists, so I'm not gonna do that, but you know, you can just see the covers. Then, from I believe the Hitomasu circle, I have this, well, a Fukuhara. Well, it's essentially a doujin, like they're pretty much all, well, most of them are doujins. But, so yeah, this is this one. I think you might have seen this artist on Twitter a lot because they're quite popular, I think. So I like Fukuhara both generations, and when I bought their book, there was also like a first and second marker. So this is, I think this one is going first and this one is going second, if I remember my kanji properly. But regardless, it's a very nice first and second marker, so I do like to use it. It's very nice. I really, really like it. So that was this one. And then I believe the circle name, or well, their Twitter handle should be ._56mgi. And this is another Fukuhara doujin. So again, I like my Fukuharas, so definitely worth it. And then Hato_MT's circle had this very nice Rami Labyrinth doujin. It's slightly, ever so slightly explicit, let's say that, but it's definitely worth the pickup. You know, I don't regret this purchase whatsoever. Then we have one of the circles releases this Stand and Draw, which is a bundle of four komas, which is like the four panel, usually funny story manga. So this is the 9th volume, and has some pretty good ones in there. I'm kind of sad I can't show, because they are quite, like, really quite good. So this was the 9th one, and I guess they release a new one every single time as well. So this one is from the circle titled their Twitter handle is NGISKN. So this is a doujin. So also quite nice. And then finally, you saw one of the Asha, like keychains that I have back there, and that circle also released a Asha doujin, so it just looks pretty. I considered this like so many times and was like, ah, should I pick it up, should I not, should I pick it up, should I not, because I don't like Asha that much, but I was like, ah, I'll pick it up. So this is the Asha doujin. It just looks like the art is so nice. I was just like, ah, even though I don't like Asha that much, I like the art, so I'm gonna do it anyway. So that was that. And then the other thing The only other thing is, you already saw it in my video on the box opening of GBT13, because I used that playmat in there, but I picked up two of the Asha and Gabriel playmat that you saw earlier. This one is for my friend, can you say G, because he asked for one, and so, yeah. The other one I'm keeping for myself, obviously, but you saw there was also an Asha playmat that was for sale that I didn't pick up, and I think next time there might be a Gabriel playmat, so that's also quite cool. So that's basically it for the merch. There might be one or two things that I simply forgot, because the event was actually a few weeks ago, and I just haven't had time to sit down and talk about it yet. So, that's gonna be it for me today. Once again, if you do create this kind of merchandise, this kind of just, like, passion work, I guess you can call it, in your own free time, then feel free to just drop me a quick mention on Twitter or something. You know, if you do that kind of thing, and I'm happy to share it, because this is just amazing to me. I couldn't stop buying stuff because I was like, oh my god, this is amazing, this is amazing, this is amazing. So it's really hard to stop yourself when you go to an event like this. So if you do go, try to be careful with your wallet, because, you know, that's the kind of thing that can happen. But stuff is cheap, like, definitely very cheap for every single product, so it's definitely very cool. So, on that note, I'm gonna wrap things up here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and maybe this was a new experience to you, maybe you haven't seen or heard about this just like I hadn't until I finally received the kind of news about it. And also, thank you to all the cosplayers that allow me to take pictures of them, of them. I also tried to keep track of every single username, or at least some of the usernames of all the cosplayers, because there were quite a lot there, because it is a Vanguard-centered convention. So, that's gonna be it for me today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and also I'm gonna start to add a new thing to the outro. Do click the bell button at the bottom to receive notifications for any future videos. So, that's me for me today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.